talked about CMDB. So basically, like they created the dashboards for you to have right out of the box on we talked about previously, they've also now created a CMDB dashboard for you so that we can, you know, understand, you know, the CIs, the ones that are getting the most changes, the ones that are getting the most usage as far as attaching to other documents, the CIs by class, you know, tying the business services in there. So if you look at that, you know, you're just going to come in like you always do under reports and dashboard. There's now just a new entry for the CMDB dashboard that you've got. And out of the box, at least in the Winter 15 release, here are your 16 different views within that CMD dashboard. I'm not going to sit here and read them, but it's what you would typically expect, right? Top five CIs by incident, top services and service requests, et cetera, et cetera. And again, those are there for you out of the box. You can clone them, you can rename them, you can customize them as you can with any other dashboard within Remedy 4. So again, another very nice addition that we've got here. There's an example of the particular dashboards, and you know, as you would expect, if you want to change the graph types and all, you can go in and do that. But you saw from the previous page what they're trying to do. So I know a lot of you will be excited about this is, you know, they've tried to make it a little bit easier to use web services in this particular release. And that usually comes about on almost any implementation that we do, or good 9 out of 10 of them, that we need some kind of web service component in here. So now the administrator can configure tasks or incidents in Remedy Force to call an external web service based on some type of event happening, with the event of the ticket or whatever. Again, the common use case that everybody could identify with is, hey, I need to provision an AD account or reset a password based on a task or an incident status update. So there's a way to go in and configure that to happen automatically from that once I've established that API. So, you know, the admin configures it. I can have multiple web methods. So if some things need to be REST, some others need to be SOAP, both tied to an incident or a task form, you know, your administrator's got the ability to be able to go out and do that. So when you do it, you basically see here we support three types. We support both REST and SOAP Basic and SOAP Advanced. We basically, like most things in Remedy Force, you go through a simple little wizard. You just identify the service type and the URL that it's going to be associated with. You then identify, you know, if necessary, if you're going to have authentication, is it the basic or is it the more advanced where you're doing the Salesforce passing of the certificates back and forth, especially if you're talking back to Salesforce itself. And then, you know, you can go in and schedule when you want these things to run. In this category, there's a little scheduler there, so I can schedule when should this task run, how often should it repeat. You know, if I have a job and it fails when I initiate that web service, how many times and how frequent should I retry to see if I can pull that data in. Again, this is not meant to be a design your web service API presentation, but just giving you the highlights that it's here for those of you who need this and who have some web service type of experience. There's great documentation here on how all this is done in there. And again, that's, you know, by default, it's going to run every 15 minutes until it completes there. And this is just an example, again, just to reiterate, I can have these web APIs go out against a service request, a task template, a workflow, a trigger within the configuration of Remedy Force, as well as bringing it in from a form or a task. Now, you know, whatever you're going to, somebody has to have already still built the web service that I'm going to go out and consume. So it's, you know, it always requires the other party to have something there. This is just automating my ability to be able to go out and to attach it in a little bit easier fashion there as we go through it. And as we get down towards the end here, one of the things they've now done is created Pentaho packages for migrating configurations from one Salesforce or worker to another. So now, excuse me, now we're going to have the ability to migrate categories, templates, service request definitions, service level agreements, quick views, which are obviously going to be very important in those new dashboards, and, you know, basic configuration like type data such as status, impact, urgency, and priority. They've now, you know, these Pentaho packages are going to come with it. There's just kind of a high level diagram of what it's going to look like. It's obviously got error logs and auditing all along the way, but being able to push that configuration data to another org within the organization is going to be big. It's something that people have been wanting for a long time, and I'm glad to see that they finally put this in here. Again, service offerings, categories, quest definitions, templates, incidents, so forth. Just you've got to make sure, though, that there is a very tight similarity between the orgs you're pushing to, because you got to be able to have the data have a receiving point in there, and I'm sure everybody kind of knows that. And then there are ways to make that work even easier. There's the way to go in and say, well, what's going to export, right? So not every field perhaps you're going to want to export. So you can go in and say, these are the fields I want to use in the Pentaho export over to the different org, and then other things you may do manually within that org. And again, that's just a list then, the categories, the configs, templates, request definitions, agreement, and quick views that we have there. And, you know, again, it's a little wizard-driven routine to basically go through and do that. And then I believe this is the last one, it is they've now, you know, ADDM does the great job of going out and discovering what's in the environment, especially from a server standpoint, you know, how they configured what's running on those and those relationships between those devices. And they've now enhanced that ability to bring that data into RemedyForce by creating the Pentaho package for migrating impact relationships right from ADDM directly into the RemedyForce CMDB. And so, you know, once you upgrade to Winter 15, this Pentaho package is right there in it, and that should simplify getting some of that good relationship data that everybody wants. And I think this will probably even increase the usage now of ADDM in a RemedyForce environment. So all in all, I think they've done a great job in bringing out new functionality and customer request enhancements in 15. So we look forward to working with you if you need some assistance.